In this illustration, we'll study about the energy transfer to a wave on a string. We are given that one end of a thin, long, uniform string having linear mass density lambda is fixed to a wall and other end with a block which can move along a vertical rail. We are given that the string is horizontal and has a tension T naught, and the block executes a stem along the rail with amplitude A and angular frequency omega. And we are required to calculate the energy transfer to a string in one oscillation of the block. Now, in this situation, we first draw the picture for better understanding. There is a rail on which there is a block to which a string is connected, and one end of the string is connected to a wall. Here, when the block starts executing oscillations simple harmonically between minus A and plus A up and down, a wave will start propagating in the string. And when the block is located at a distance y from its initial position, the string would be having such a shape like this. And the wave starts propagating in the string with a velocity v, which is given as root of T naught by lambda, as tension in the string is T naught and lambda is the linear mass density of the string. Now, in this situation, the block is going up with a velocity vy, and if we consider the string is having a tangential tension T naught, so this tension will be extracting energy from the block. So, if we write down the SHM equation of block, this SHM equation we can write as y is A sine of omega t. And due to this, if we talk about the wave which is propagating in the string, so wave equation in a string, as we already discussed in concept videos, we can write it A sine of omega t minus kx, where the value of k is omega by v, or the angular wave number in the string. So from here, we first calculate the slope of this string at point x equals to 0. We consider this direction as plus x axis. And here we can write the slope of a string is, this we write as tan theta in magnitude, this is del y by del x, and on further differentiating this expression with respect to x only, this minus a k cos of omega t minus kx. And at x equals to 0, the value of tan theta we are getting is minus a k cos of omega t. And if we calculate the velocity of this particle when it is at a distance y and at time t, so velocity of block at time t is Vy, we can write as del y by del t, that is calculated by A omega cos of omega t only, because we are calculating it at x equals to 0, or we simply differentiate the equation of SHM of block. Now, in this situation, if T naught is the tension in a string, we can directly write down power supplied by block to a string is, this power we can write as T naught sine theta multiplied by Vy, as T naught cos theta is perpendicular to its motion and T naught sine theta is the force which is extracting energy from block to the string, for which block is exerting T naught sine theta on a string in upward direction. So, for a small theta, we can approximate it as T naught tan theta multiplied by Vy. On substituting the values, T naught, the value of tan theta, here we can write as we already calculated in magnitude as AK cos of omega t multiplied by Vy is A omega cos of omega t. So, this is giving us the value of power as T naught A square K, we can write as omega by V. We already know the value of angular wave number is omega by V, or it can be written as 2 pi by lambda. So, this A square omega square by V cos square omega T. So, this is the power we are getting, and if we continue from here, we can write energy supplied in one oscillation to string is, this total energy we can write as integration of P dt. For one oscillation, we integrate it from 0 to 2 pi by omega. And if we integrate this function, this is T naught A square omega square by V. This is cos square omega T dt, and we are integrating it from 0 to 2 pi by omega. So, here I am leaving it as an exercise for you to integrate this function, which is quite simple. You can open it in twice angle form as 1 plus cos 2 omega T by 2 and integrate it. So, this gives us the value of final energy as T naught A square omega pi by V. The value of V we can substitute as root of T naught by lambda. So, this gives us root of T naught lambda multiplied by A square omega pi. That is the result of this problem.